shame on the politicians, NDC, MPP, right from chairman all the way to the last person on the NDC side, on the MPP side, shame on them. And I say shame on them because when the matter suits them or the matter suits them, they go out there and make statements. Mm-hmm. Then when the tables turn, they make statements. So they are playing victors and victim at the same time. Shame on you. Shame on you because as politicians since 1992, both NDC and MPP, you know that as ACP Dr. Gozo said, the composition of the police council has a problem. And has a problem because it affords politicians to have a control of our security situation. And you know it. And you have not changed it. And you take advantage of it. Shame on you. Shame on you because, look, I've listened to the security couples at the Justice Emil Short Commission. I don't believe, look, having grown up in the barracks, I don't believe that our people are incompetent. I believe that something is wrong somewhere. And that something wrong somewhere is political influence. Mm-hmm. It happens in NDC. It happens under MPP. Now, you and I know, whether we choose to call them, ushers or vigilantes, or they are criminals and hoodlums. And we've decided to clothe them in that. Who appointed them vigilantes? Who said our security agencies are not able to handle the situation? And yet, both of you take advantage of it to get your... You're just power thirsty. You're just power thirsty, and people are losing their lives. People are living in fear. People are feeling insecure. And you come back and you say the police is not able to handle the situation. Shame on you. Shame on you because you know what is right. And this is today, the floating voter out there. Look, let me tell you this today. They make you believe that NDC, without NDC and MPP, we can never make progress in this country. That's a lie. Because look at all the electoral records we have had. NDC can never get that 50 plus one votes or 50% plus one vote on their own with just their members. Same for MPP. They can never ever at any election in this country, and I can put my salary on it, they can never ever ever get 50% plus one vote on their own with just their members. They need you, the floating voter, to always come along with them. Should we punish them at the polls, or should we just follow them because they come and give us hand downs with these people at the helm of affairs? They cause mayhem. Look at just what happened. Look at what happened. Somebody has lost a breadwinner. Look at just what happened.
Anyway,
it's so pathetic. It's so shameful. And we have all been playing the ostrich with it. Look, the IGP, I feel sorry for him. He's been appealing to the political parties just because. And look, just yesterday when the matter came up, we're told that somebody somewhere within the party suggested or gave four names to be picked up. Yeah. And meaning that they know these people. Those within the parties, they know them. I'm sure if you go to MPP and you want to check out the names of the persons at the IASO West Wogon, they know the people. You are thinking why DSP Azugu yesterday decided that he was going to write the name of the person who assaulted Honorable Sam George on a piece of paper and he calls it in camera, when we are not ready to name and shame. They know the people who are behind it, but they are not willing to do it. How many times have we been as a nation called for the fact that these vigilante groups must be disbanded? How many times have we called for it? What has happened in the matter of disbanding these vigilante groups? And you come back and you want to make us believe that as political parties, both NDC and MPP, because you are enjoying duopoly, unfortunately, you believe that you will play ping pong with the people of Ghana and risk our lives. People have to go to school. People must not live in fear. People must be able to speak up their minds and be safe. People must live in insanity. You can't continue to put people's lives in danger because somebody decided to become a police officer and there's wildfire, and so he doesn't have ammunition, and so he will be shot by some stray bullet because some ill-treated or ill-trained person is put up there as a vigilante. Shame on you if you're a politician and you are behind this. You are funding them, you are feeding the boys, you are calling them, you are encouraging them. Shame on you. Shame on you. I'm not happy with you.
Anyway, guys, let's put some brakes on it and take a